Alrighty, welcome back into the Media Center at the Ascendant LPGA Benefiting Volunteers of America. We are joined by the 2019 champion, Cheyenne Knight. Cheyenne, how does it feel to be back here in your home state?
It feels great. This is an event that I look forward to every year. I have great memories here. I've become like pretty good friends with like the staff out here. They've been great to me, and I'm a member here. Don't make it all the way over here as much as I'd like. Not home that much. But yeah, it feels great, and the course is in good shape considering like just how hot of a summer it's been, and they've worked really hard to get the course ready for us.
You talked about good memories. In 2019 when you won, was there what do you remember about that win, and you know, anything you'd love to share with us?
Yeah, that was my rookie year, and it was really hard for me to get adjusted my rookie year just to the competition on the LPGA and like kind of like finding my footing. And so the last tournament, I needed a top five finish to keep my job for next year, keep my card. And yeah, I kind of had nothing to lose. And yeah, it was just so special just to win in front of like my friends and family who, you know, my grandma was there. My grandma's coming back this year. So I'm really excited that she gets to be here and see that. And just, you know, we play all over the world. So just being able to drive here and stay at my house and just don't get that very often.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's special to win on tour in general, but just, you know, you're one of the few who can probably speak on how special is it to win on tour and in your home state?
Yeah, I think me and Angela have talked about that a good bit. Like, some people say it's harder to win like in front of like your friends and your family and your home state just because you want it so badly. But yeah, I mean, having that as my first LPGA win and just like in the home state of Texas. And yeah, I mean, it's incredible. And like this tournament, when it used to be at Las Clinas, that was my first LPGA event I've ever played. So I have a lot of history with this event. And it was just like picture perfect in 2019.
Yeah, absolutely. You kind of mentioned it in your previous answer, but you know, your first win here in 2019, your rookie year, you got your second win this season at Dow. How do you think you've grown either in your game or as a person since in between those two wins?
Yeah, I think when I won my rookie year, you know, it was kind of like a Hail Mary, I guess. It was kind of like do or die. I needed a top finish, like keep my cards. So like that week I had like nothing to lose. And I think it's just really hard to win out here. Like there's so much depth, and you know, I've been in contention a good bit, like kind of earlier the year, and it's just hard to like piece it together. And like me and Elizabeth winning, like it's just really difficult like to win out here. But to win Dow was such a unique event. You know, I get to play with one of my best friends, and so to experience both of that together was really cool, but different than when you're out there by yourself and, you know, being in contention and like kind of feeling those nerves, just something you kind of have to get used to and embrace. So, yeah, two very different wins, but like being in contention, like there's nothing like it. You can't really prepare for like what you're going to feel until you're there in that moment.
Absolutely. It, you know, this is our first chance getting to talk to you since Solheim. I'd be remiss if I didn't ask about it. Just, I know it was a great week, a long week, but how would you summarize it, you know, in a few sentences, you know, your first Solheim experience?
And, you know, everyone says it's like the best week of your life, but it really was. It was incredible. I had so much fun with the captains, with my teammates, you know, just getting to play in that competitive environment. You know, I've never really had that many people watch me or cheer me on or not cheer for me, I guess. But, you know, I think, yeah, that's my first time representing my country. It was like a huge goal, and to play under Stacy was awesome. And, you know, to hear my name being said, like representing the United States of America, like that's probably like my biggest accomplishment thus far.
Yeah, absolutely. Any questions in the media center?
Did you hear on the final day all the Texas songs everyone was singing as you were teeing it up on the first hole? And what did that mean to you to hear? What's the name of the song? The Texas song?
Oh, yeah. Deep in the Heart of Texas.
Deep in the Heart of Texas. Yeah.
You know, you're so nervous in that environment. You know, you're ready to just hit the first tee shot and kind of get going. And to just kind of hear the people kind of like sing Deep in the Heart of Texas and put my name in it was so special all the way in Spain, you know. All our fans that came out and supported us. And I played like the last few holes with Leona today, and she's like, you guys had a lot of people out there. So big shout out to everyone that came and represented Texas as well.
Having played in your first Solheim now, and another one coming up in just, you know, less than a year, are you excited? How big of a goal is it to be on that team again and to be able to tee it up in the name of your country again?
Yeah, huge goal, like, to make it next year. Definitely got, like, the taste of it this year and definitely want to be back and, you know, experience that all again with the girls. And, yeah, kind of left a sour taste in our mouth, I think, kind of ending the way it did. You know, we were so close, but that's the beauty of team sports, right? Or just sports in general. Yeah, so huge. I just hope I can keep doing what I'm doing and just be on that team and getting to play in the U.S., like close to Washington, D.C., is going to be really cool.
And Matt may have touched on this one a little bit at the top, but coming out of the Solheim Cup, you played great. You carried your momentum last week into Walmart. So talk about Solheim Cup, Walmart, and then kind of keeping that momentum going into this week in your hometown event.
Yeah, people thought I was a little crazy to play Arkansas right after Solheim. But, you know, I love Arkansas and this tournament just because it's close to home and play well on these golf courses. And so I think Solheim gave me just kind of rejuvenated me, I guess, like, because the season is, like, a really long grind, and I wasn't playing, like, too well before Solheim, but just, like, having so much fun and kind of different environment, like, finding the joy and all that kind of, like, mentally kind of made me a little bit fresher for Arkansas, and I hope I can carry it into this week. Like, my game feels in a pretty good spot, but, you know, it's October. We've been going since February, so just kind of at the end, and hope I can kind of like carry that momentum into this week as well.
And we touched on this on media day a little bit, but you probably see it all over the course. Her signature is on the back of the trophy. So just Kathy Whitworth, how much did she mean to this tournament and how much did she mean to you as growing up here in Texas?
Yeah, I played in her junior event growing up in Fort Worth, and just, you know, 88 wins. She's a legend. I feel like Kathy Whitworth, you don't really need to say, like, too much past her name to, like, know who she is and just, like, the legend that she is. And, yeah, and, like, she was there when I won. And, you know, I remember just her, like, growing up in the junior tournaments that I went to and talking to her. And, you know, like, sad that she's not with us, but we honored her at Solheim, and it's awesome to see, like, all the touches that the tournament is done this week to remember her and just, like, the awesome person that she was. And, you know, we talked a lot about, like, her legacy at Solheim Cup, like, had 88 on our hats for her. And, you know, she probably had, like, the worst self-talk on the golf course, but she was such a fierce competitor, and she could just, like, turn it off and turn it on. So it's really special, and just, you know, sad that she's not with us, but it's awesome that we can remember her.
Last one for me, sorry. Everyone who wins this tournament gets a pair of cowboy boots, and we're just wondering where yours are and how have you worn them, or what's happening with those boots?
I don't think they started that when I won. just the trophy. Okay.
All right, that'll do it. Thank you so much, Cheyenne.
Thanks.